you've been a gamer for the past 2 decades, chances are that Metal Gear Solid is still one of those games you would label as a classic, and with good reason. This is a game that elevated gaming to a whole new level when it released back in September of 1998. So how does it hold up almost 17 years later? Pretty well, actually. Don't get me wrong, certain aspects are beginning to show some age, but it's still just as clever as ever. It's definitely a Hideo Kojima game, a man whose dictionary omits the word simplicity, for better or for worse, and a man who is always pushing the boundaries of gaming forward. Metal Gear Solid tells the tale of the Shadow Moses incident. The year is 2005, and the latest incarnation of secret weapon of mass destruction Metal Gear, Metal Gear Rex, is being finalized by the US government in the fictitious Shadow Moses Island. Unfortunately for them, the island has been overrun by a terrorist group called Foxhound, and its leader is none other than Liquid Snake, the twin brother of our protagonist Solid Snake. Foxhound's demands are simple. The US government is to hand over the remains of once legendary soldier Big Boss along with $1 billion within 24 hours or risk a nuclear attack launched by their own creation. It is up to Solid Snake to infiltrate Shadow Moses and thwart the terrorist threat. But of course, in classic Hideo Kojima fashion, things aren't what they seem. Conspiracies and unexpected twists and turns abound in this well-constructed 10-hour adventure, keeping players constantly engaged and curious about what's around the next corner. The plot is further enhanced by its mature yet over-the-top style, making what could have otherwise been a typical American spy stopping a weapon of mass destruction story incredibly unique and entertaining. Kojima essentially took the cliché genre and refreshed it by making a gritty yet fun comic book version that features everything from a charming badass protagonist with distinguishable features and a cool attitude, over-the-top villains with awesome supernatural powers and ridiculous agendas, to a convoluted story infused with pseudo-history and terms that make no damn sense to the average Joe and yet somehow remains intriguing throughout. It's not all bombastic, though. Even amidst all the craziness, the game manages to find the time to be subtle by providing some truly touching moments for the myriad of interesting characters that players meet, and it manages to be profound and express themes and ideas that leave a lasting impression, giving the story that extra oomph, even if some of the story elements can be heavy-handed at times. The game also manages to be incredibly funny and clever on many occasions, thanks to its fourth-wall-breaking jokes and its constant self-awareness. But what truly elevates Metal Gear Solid to a completely different dimension from its prequels is the way the story is presented. Whereas the old Metal Gear games presented their story through text-based dialogue, Metal Gear Solid makes use of animated codec conversations, as well as cinematic cutscenes, both of which are fully voice-acted. As a result, Metal Gear Solid's story comes to life in a way that its prequels never did, making it feel much more tangible. And these aren't the cheesy live-action cutscenes or subpar CGI cutscenes that were commonplace at the time. The game uses the in-game 3D engine to render its high-quality cinematics, blurring the line between story and gameplay and making for a very immersive experience. The term playing a movie comes to mind, and no other game did anything quite like it at the time. Admittedly, the cutscenes can look a bit silly at times with the blocky character models, low-resolution textures, and missing eyeballs.
They're rookie's eyes if I ever saw them.
But Kojima and team did what they could with the hardware limitations of an era where graphics like these were considered to be top-notch. Still, there is no denying that they haven't aged very well, but the technical limitations are more than made up by the game's artistic direction. The game's moody industrial atmosphere, along with its fantastic foreboding soundtrack, are constantly there to remind players that danger is ever present. Like its prequels, danger is to be avoided at all costs in Metal Gear Solid through the use of stealth, as engaging enemies directly will often result in overwhelming odds against survival. Metal Gear Solid borrows heavily from the arcade-style stealth gameplay established by Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake, so much so that I would say Metal Gear Solid is, in its most basic form, a 3D version of Metal Gear 2. In fact, if you play the two games one after another, you will notice that some of the parallels are quite staggering. But Metal Gear Solid isn't just a copy-and-paste job. The series' shift to 3D allowed for significant improvements to be made along the way. One of the biggest issues I had with the 2D Metal Gear games is that Snake felt stiff to move around, which was just the nature of how pixel sprites and games worked in general back then. That's been rectified in Metal Gear Solid. Snake's movement is now buttery smooth, allowing players to hide and strike with agility and precision. Furthermore, new abilities like leaning against walls, choke-holding guards, and entering first-person view mode are welcome additions that further expand Snake's stealth arsenal. World traversal has also been significantly enhanced. While the game mainly retains the bird's-eye view of its prequels, players are no longer confined to square grids. Instead, entire areas of all shapes and sizes can now be traversed seamlessly with a dynamic camera that constantly follows Snake. This also means that soldiers can patrol and interact with entire areas, making stealth more realistic and intense, especially where detection is concerned. In Metal Gear 2, it was easy to escape detection thanks to its grid system, which allowed the use of exploits that essentially rendered the game's detection system almost obsolete. In Metal Gear Solid, on the other hand, the threat of detection is very real. Walk into a guard's cone of vision and expect to have an entire squad relentlessly hunting after you until you manage to find a good hiding spot. The AI of Metal Gear Solid's soldiers isn't without its flaws, but their ruthlessness, along with their keen perception for things like suspicious movement, sound, and even things like footprints, make them formidable foes. And speaking of formidable foes, expect to encounter numerous bosses throughout Shadow Moses. Even today, these are some of the best, most clever, and most iconic boss battles in gaming history. Not a single boss feels wasted or generic. Their distinct specialties, powers, and attributes make each encounter feel like its own unique experience that tests the mastery of a specific gameplay mechanic or weapon in the game, and their distinct personalities give each battle a unique flavor. The battle against Psycho Mantis in particular is something that gamers are quite fond of, even after all these years. These bosses are not only diverse and fun to fight, they make for some compelling and interesting characters. Defeating a boss often yields backstory, revealing events in their lives that made them who they are and the philosophies they have come to develop as a result, all of which ties into the game's themes, ideas, and messages. To battle these bosses, players will have to overcome a world design that borrows heavily from Metal Gear 1 and 2's card key system of progression. World design is one area where I think Metal Gear Solid takes a step back from its prequel. Not that it's bad, and improvements like backwards compatible card keys make traversing the world significantly more intuitive, but Shadow Moses never reaches Zanzibar Land's level of intricacy. It feels like a smaller, more compact, albeit prettier version of what the prequel had to offer. The only reason Metal Gear Solid can run longer than Metal Gear 2 is because of the long cutscenes. Skip those and you will find that Metal Gear Solid is a pretty short game with a relatively simple world design. Fortunately, there is more variety to the things you get to see and do as you traverse the world, and the vast improvements in presentation, which can be attributed to the excellent artistic direction, cutscenes, and voice acting, makes up for the reduced level of intricacy in world design. Another setback is combat, which can often be unwieldy. The developers recognized that aiming manually in a 3D environment with a bird's-eye view camera would be unintuitive for players, which is why they introduced a new lock-on feature. Unfortunately, the lock-on feature can be finicky at best, making aiming and shooting in this game a hit or miss. It's still better than not having it at all, but there is definitely room for improvement. I also have to criticize the sniper rifle mechanics, which can make the weapon a pain in the ass to use. When equipped, the sniper rifle takes away all semblance of control from the player for a second or two by forcing Snake into a first-person prone position every time it's equipped. It's both frustrating and disorienting, especially when the sniper rifle is equipped by accident. Fortunately, the game doesn't emphasize combat all that much, making the lackluster lock-on feature and sniper rifle mechanics a non-issue for most of the game, and it works well enough during boss battles, but do expect some frustrations once in a while. I do have to commend the new weapons and item switching interface, though. The game gets rid of the separate menus from its prequels and instead employs a system that allows players to hold down a shoulder button, L2 for items and R2 for weapons, to pause the game and bring up an unobtrusive interface through which they can cycle through their various gear. Players can also quickly equip or unequip a selected item or weapon by pressing L1 or R1 respectively. With this new system, not only is the process of selecting gear much faster, intuitive, and seamless, it's also more immersive, as there is no longer a jarring separation between the game and its menus. Everything feels like one cohesive unit now, instead of separate components. This may seem like a minor detail, but it makes a world of difference. The Metal Gear series makes some dramatic changes and additions as it makes its debut in the third dimension, but it's the attention to the little, seemingly minor details that elevates Metal Gear Solid to the status of masterpiece and classic. It's by no means a perfect game, but it's my belief that a classic isn't defined by technical perfection, but by genre-defining moments and accomplishments, and there's just so much that Metal Gear Solid accomplishes. It tells a story that is as thoroughly entertaining as it is thought-provoking. Its arcade-style stealth gameplay is the best it's been, perfectly suited for the new 3D world design, and the game is constantly intelligent and clever in every aspect, from storytelling, gameplay, presentation, to humor, in a way that no other game is, even today. The intricacy of its world design does get sacrificed a bit to make way for the game's cinematic storytelling, and combat does leave something to be desired, but as an overall package, Metal Gear Solid is on a level of its own. Metal Gear Solid is a triumph, and one of gaming's greatest and most important treasures. Anyone who considers themselves a gamer should give this game a shot if they haven't done so yet.